I will bless the Lord at all times, and His praise shall continually be in my mouth. You are welcome to our midweek service of Calvary Baptist Church. We believe that God is Lord and King, and is doing mighty things. So you are welcome on behalf of our senior pastor, Reverend Dr. Fred Digbe, his pastors and team of leaders. We welcome you to our midweek service, which is on the 29th of April, believing that God has power and blessings in store for you. I want us to know that Jesus Christ is Lord and is King. He loves you so much. We know that many of us are going through difficult times. We are at home, some are in the offices and whatever. We've lost our loved ones and all other things are happening. But we want you to know that there's power in prayer. And as we come before the Lord, like the psalmist says, come before Him with singing and with praise and with thanksgiving. So we want to start off by offering prayer unto the Lord. Shall we pray that the Lord God Almighty will move mightily through this service, whatever it is that you are going through, whatever burden, that God will speak to you, that God will minister. So we are praying, Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray for the atmosphere, we pray for the time. It's a special time in your presence. We pray that everyone that is listening to the sound of our voice will be blessed this evening. We want to thank you so much that you are a prayer answering God. Let's pray also for those who are sick, those who are not feeling well, those who are discouraged, depressed, whatever they are. Let's pray for them that the mighty hand of God will minister to them as the word of God comes this evening. That God, who ministers to the needs of people, will lift up their burden. So we are praying, wherever you are, let's pray, lift up your voice, pray for your family, pray for your brothers and sisters, pray for your loved ones, pray for the doctors, the nurses, pray for everyone that needs a prayer this evening. We are praying for them. They are born by you. Just pray, commit the time that we're going to have into God's hands, that God will minister, God will speak to us. It's going to be a wonderful time in the presence of the Lord. You know, we have an enemy who does not want our welfare. He comes in with all kinds of lies, deception, and it's the devil. Let's pray and take authority over everything assigned to this session tonight. We want to pray that the Spirit of God will minister, break every barrier, any addiction, fear, discouragement, whatever it is. We are praying that the mighty hand of God will move mightily in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, have your way, have your way, have your way in this session, oh God, as we come with the word of God reaching into every home, touching people wherever they are. In the name of Jesus, we pray with thanksgiving. Amen. The psalmist says, enter his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. We want to come to a time of adoring God. Remember that there's nobody like God. There's no other king, no other God like our God. I want to adore Him. We want to worship Him. Lift up your voice wherever you are. It is the dead that cannot praise God, but the living shall praise the Lord and bless Him and adore Him. Bless the Lord at all times and let His praise be known unto all over the world. As long as we live, we will worship the Lord. And so as we worship the Lord, lift up your hands, worship Him, adore Him, celebrate His goodness, for the Lord is good and His mercies endure forever.
You are God, Elohim, Ancient of Days, reign, there is none like you, Lord, Ancient of Days, reign. You are God, you are God, Elohim, Ancient of Days, reign. There is none like you, Lord, like you, Lord, Ancient of Days, reign. You are God,
you
Elohim,
alone is worthy of worship. There's no God, there's no king. He alone is worthy. From the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, your majesty, your excellency, we bless you, we adore him. Who can we compare unto him? There's no other king, there's no God like him. The one who died, he laid down his life, and on the dead day he resurrected. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and everything that within me. Bless his holy name. Worship the Lord, exalt him, and bless him. Come on, go ahead, worship him. But there's no God, there's no king, there's none like him. The living of the Lord, the El Shaddai, the bread of life, the living water, the great I am that I am. Elohim is his name. We worship him. We call him Abba Father. The great I am that I am. He is exalted. We give you worship. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give. Don't keep going. Go ahead. Worship him. Exalt him. For this God is a wonderful God. Lifted above the heavens and the earth. And everything shall bow. Everything on earth in the heavens above shall worship and adore him. For his king. Look at what the psalmist says in Psalm 124. If the Lord had not been on our side, let Israel say so. If the Lord had not been on our side, when people attacked us, they would have swallowed us alive. When their anger fled against us, and the flood would have engulfed us, and the torrent would have swept over us, and the raging waters would have swept us away. Verses. Praise be to the Lord who has not let us be torn by their teeth. We have escaped like a bird from the fowler's snare. The snare has been broken and we have escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Our help is in the name of the Lord. Come on, lift up your voice and thank God that he's your helper. Where God is your helper, there's nobody more compared. Ni banya ye boa boy, o bibere ni kono mabeti mi e boa wo ye nyankopo onu ne boa ye. It is God ye nyekarento. He's our helper. Continue to worship and thank him for the help. The Bible says, if the Lord had not been on our side, if the Lord had not been on our side, if the Lord had not been on our side, let Israel say so. Beloved, it's not your strength, it's not your power, it's not your resources, it is not who you know, it is not your prestige, it is not your status. It is the Lord. Lift up your voice and thank him for the help he has offered you this far. The Lord has been good to us as a nation. Thank God for the borders. He has watched over our going and our coming. He's preserved you. When you lie down, when you rise up, he said, our help is in the name of the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He controls the universe. Can we come before him? Maybe you complained. Maybe you murmured. Maybe you did not appreciate him. He says, count your blessings, name them one by one. How many blessings have you counted today? You are among the living, you are not dead. Thank him. Remember, it's a midweek service and we are thanking God. It's a prayer service. It's a miracle service. God is doing something with this service. Just thank him. Thank you for your family. Those outside the country. Those in the country. Thank you for your children. Thank you for your brothers and sisters. Thank you for your enemy. Thank you for even those who have offended you. Thank God. Thank God. Bless him. Blessing is worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. Our help is in the name of the Lord. If there's anything we need to go before the Lord and to tell him we are sorry, tell him we are sorry. The sins of the world, our individual sins. We have offended him in several ways. We are ungrateful. We have taken his blessings for granted. We don't love one another. We have walked away from the truth. And we have gone our own ways. But he's calling us back to himself. Pray that the blood of Jesus will cleanse the world from sin, from everything we have done against the Lord. And I pray that God will make you a blessing to somebody, a blessing to your members of your household, a blessing to those in the community. commit this time into God's hands. Ask that the Lord will bless. I can minister one. Can we just lift up one song of adoration one more time? As we get ready to usher the speaker and the time of prayer. A word of a song of adoration. Just worship the Lord. Just worship.
Oh, be lifted.
Come on, be lifted.
Above all other gods.
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
We lay our crowns and worship you. Oh, be lifted.
Come on, lift him up above every other name.
Above all
He's greater than every power. He's greater than any demon. He's greater than anything. He's the King of Kings and the Lord.
Worship. Oh, be lifted, sing.
Oh, be lifted.
Above all other gods.
Above all other gods.
Glorious God,
I will lay our crowns and will worship you. He's worthy of our worship. Everything be silent in his presence. Oh, he's Lord. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
You are welcome to Calvary Baptist Church, where we are streaming on Facebook, Calvary Baptist Church, GH, and on YouTube, Calvary Baptist Church TV. On radio, we are on Sunny 88.7 on Sundays at 10 a.m. and on Power FM 97.9 on Sundays at 9 a.m. So you're welcome. I remember that our offices are opened from Monday to Friday, from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. Mondays to Fridays. You can come and do business as usual. However, as you come, come with your face masks, your nose masks, and also protect yourself as you come. And I want to usher in a servant of the Lord, Calvary Baptist Church, at Shashi Adabraka Oyibi Amasama Botiano. We are blessed with seasoned men and women of God. And one of the servants of God that has been chosen to lead us in this prayer time is a servant of the Lord who loves the Lord so much. And he's in the person of Reverend Dan Annan, who will lead us in exhortation and a time of prayer. Let's welcome him with a clap offering unto the Lord, celebrating the goodness of God as he comes.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Beloved, today is a prayer time. I don't know what you've gone through from Monday, Tuesday, and today. But I believe that tomorrow shall be different. Whatever the enemy has placed on you, we trust God that as we pray, that burden shall be lifted. I want you, wherever you are, to just rise on your feet, get up from your couch, and just lift up your hands and pray and ask God to give you the strength to go through this time of prayer. Shall we go to the Lord in prayer? Everything that you have been through, on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday that is not of God, pray and cancel it in the name of Jesus Christ. That on Thursday and Friday it shall be better.
Say yawada or try ya one if you are there, a bessie we ye.
Strike out of your prison, come out of your prison, pray.
Break
every chain that enemy has placed upon you. Every heaviness that he has placed on you, come out of it, pray and break that chain in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name.
Oh, yes, Christo,
amen.
Amen.
Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time of prayer. And as we come before you, we know that you answer our prayer. And we know that things will be different. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Beloved, today we're looking at God's love. And the subtitle is, Do Not Doubt His Promise.
Yen asa yeshe, erade do. Nani ejina so de eka radia sabine se ema wajin enya untawatawa wo erade dohun.
We are taking our text from Genesis chapter 16 and verses 1 to 6.
Yakin kaunin bes asembe fi mose guma edikain eti dun siya bakuko si siya.
We'll read in English.
Ebe kain wo brofu kase mu.
After that we'll read in Akan.
Yebesa akan wo akan kase mu nso.
Genesis chapter 16 verses 1 to 6. Now Sarai, Abram's wife, had borne him no children, but she had an Egyptian maidservant named Hagar. So she said to Abram, The Lord has kept me from having children. Go sleep with my maidservant. Perhaps I can build a family through her. Abram agreed to what Sarah said. So after Abram had been living in Canaan 10 years, Sarah, his wife, took an Egyptian maidservant, Hagar, and gave her to a husband to be his wife. He slept with Hagar, and she conceived. When she knew she was pregnant, she began to despise her mistress. Then Sarai said to Abram, You are responsible for the wrong I am suffering. I put my servant in your arms, and now she knows she is pregnant. She despises me. May the Lord judge between you and me. Your servant is in your hands, Abram said. Do with her whatever you think best. Then Sarai mistreated Hagar, so she fled from her. Beloved, Genesis chapter 16, verses 1 to 6. We'll now listen to the scripture from the Akan Bible.
Yakin kan sem no yebesa ye huwo Mose huma edikan ti du insia ni mu ba kon edikosi insia etifi asem no osi Hagar ni Ishmael na Abram yere Sarai enwo emmano na o afunabi a oye Mizrim ni a ni dindi Hagar mienu na Sarah kachre Abram se she erade esi o ma wo hu kwan enti ko mafna inchen ebia menya ne ho emma na abram tie sarai na abram tna kena na sasi so infishia duno abram yere sara fa nafna hegan a oye mizrim ni no de no ma ni kunu abram aware enano na oko hega ho no na onyinseni na ohun se wanyinsen no Obu ne ra enimtia enum na Sarah kachre Abram se asemone a wedimida asemone a wedimida oso me na mede mafna mato kukumu na ohun se wenyin se inti obu me enimtia na erade imu me ne wo ntem aten e na Abraham kachre Sarah se she wafna wo wonsem Yeno senia eye weniso. Na Sara bre no ase. Na ugwan fi ni chen. Erade asemni. Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Beloved, when God called Abraham in Genesis chapter 12.
Abraham.
He called him with a promise.
Ode boshe eka ofra
ofre. That promise was loaded with blessings.
Na boshe ode man na enshire ayemu ma.
And Abraham obeyed God.
Na Abraham yesutie ama Awurade.
Now in Genesis chapter 15 also.
Na Mose gumedikati du enum no nso no.
We read that God reaffirmed his promise to Abraham.
Onyakopon san be share ne boshe no mu kena ama Abraham.
In fact, he took Abraham outside of his tent.
Ofre Abraham fi ni demu.
And he asked him to look up into the sky. And he told him to count the stars if he could count. And he says, so shall your offspring be. And the Bible says that Abraham believed God. And he credited it to him as righteousness. Today as we pray, may God reaffirm his promise for you today. May God take you out of unbelief and fear and lift up your head. That is bowed
down.
As you lift up your head, the psalmist says that I will lift up my eyes unto the hills. From whence cometh my help? My help cometh from the Lord who made heaven and earth. Our help comes from the Lord. When Abraham looked up to the skies, he might have seen stars and the darkness. But God gave him the eye of faith. And instead of stars, he saw the suns. And instead of darkness, he saw daughters. Beloved, the natural eye looks at the natural things.
And
sees the natural things. But by faith in God, we see things that are not seen. And impossible situations become possible. Beloved, I want to request that you trust in the Lord. No matter what you're going through. Now, after 10 years, in Genesis chapter 16, we read that Sarah gave Hagar a handmaid to Abraham.
You can say, Abraham and Sarah, I did not know. Hey guy, Edem Abraham so one
now that was allowed in their tradition in that dispensation. But in this our time, it is an adultery. And we are expected to have one wife or one husband. But Abraham and Hagar were distracted from the promise of God.
Abraham any Sarah.
But there are some things that distract us from the promise and blessings of God. We want to look at just three things quickly. One is well-meaning people who are sincerely wrong. For example, Abraham was influenced by Sarah.
Abraham, neither Sarah, and share no money
for you. Wrong beliefs and practices.
The atosumi enu jidia enye nansu yeye.
And then number three, dependence on natural abilities.
The atosumi ensa yese wode wuhubetu wiasi niyamaso.
Sarah was barren, but they believed that they had Hagar who could fill in for Sarah.
Na ye mama Sarah wonwo eninti no wo ye na dwen se obema na bawa awo ama no.
Beloved, let's fast track it quickly.
Mummy achi adwen kwa chiri.
In Genesis 18,
Moses gumedikati du ngotwe no.
The Lord came to Abraham again.
Erade ba Abraham ho biom.
And he asked him,
obisa ne se,
is anything too hard for the Lord?
Bibi wo ho aye mi erade yo na na.
Today God is asking you.
Erade bisa o mi
ya. Is anything too hard for him to do?
Bibi erade yo na na.
There is nothing that is too hard for the Lord to do.
Bibi ni ho aye erade den.
And the Lord gave a promise to Abraham again.
Eni ti erade ma Abraham bo shede biom.
He said, I will return to you at the appointed time next year. God is a God who is faithful. And at the appointed time, Abraham had a son.
Abraham
who was about 99 years old.
Abraham
and he was able to have a son. Because with God, nothing is impossible. Today, as we pray, we want to stand and believe that nothing is impossible for God to do. Men might have said it is impossible. But we affirm that with God, all things are possible. Jesus told Martha, your brother will rise again. Your brother who had been dead for 4 days,
he said
he will rise again. And they took him to the graveside. And he said, take away the stone. Today God is telling you to roll away every unbelief. Anything that is stopping you from receiving from God. The Bible says roll it away. And Jesus commanded
Lazarus.
Lazarus who was dead. He said, Lazarus, come out. And Lazarus came out. The dead person heard the voice of Jesus Christ. Today, whatever is dead in your life, whatever is dead in your family, whatever is dead in your business, as we stand and pray, we are speaking to principalities and powers, and they will listen. They will bow, and they will give way. We are breaking every chain of the enemy and declaring that today is our day of liberty. For we serve a God who is almighty. And we know that with him all things are possible. Brothers and sisters, our God is a way maker. Where there is no way, he can make a way. Our God is a promise keeper. Because he is faithful. Our God is a bondage breaker. There is no bondage or chain that he cannot break. Today you will have your deliverance. Today God will deliver you. From every fear, from every addiction, from every sin, he is able to do exceedingly abundantly more than we can ask or imagine. Oh, our God is a covenant-keeping God. He is a covenant-keeping God. His covenant name is Jehovah Rapha. God, our healer. And today he will heal you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Beloved, we are getting ready to pray. And I believe that if you are sitting on your couch in the hall, with your family,
yes,
grab their hands and rise.
Yes, Lord.
Rise from your seat.
Yes.
Even as we go into prayer. Genesis 12:1-3, we read that God said, called Abraham and said, go from your country.
Abraham, Yakupon friend, the catcher, and said, fee, Ukromo.
And from your people, and from your father's household, to the land I will show you. Sometimes you need to leave your comfort zone.
Jesus.
Sometimes God will take you out of your comfort zone.
Jesus.
To be able for him to do what he wants to do in your life. They brought a blind man to Jesus. And Jesus took the blind man out of the village.
Yes, Christopher, and if friend, if you're grand, I say, Echo Dra, baby.
Before he healed him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
After the healing, he said, don't go into the village. Oh, our God is a wonderful God.
In Jesus' name.
Today we believe that the plans and the promises that he has for you, as we pray, there shall be a manifestation.
In Jesus' name.
I believe that you will come with a testimony.
Yes, Lord.
That you called upon the name of Jesus.
Yes.
And he answered your prayer.
Yes.
You will give a testimony.
In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Beloved, want to pray. Our first prayer. We are saying, Lord, open my ears. Open my eyes. That I may hear you. That I may see you.
Jesus' name.
that I'll know the direction for my life. Beloved, shall we begin prayer?
In the name of Jesus.
Begin prayer that your eyes
Father,
shall be open.
We ask for direction, so God.
We ask for
that your
counsel.
Ears will be open.
That our ears may be open,
you will
to you.
See God's promise.
That we will hear your word and your counsel.
You will hear God's voice.
We will hear you, Lord, speak.
And you know the
in
direction.
In the name of Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
In the name of the Lord Jesus.
Anything that will try to
we
hinder.
We pray against any destruction.
God's direction for your life.
Yes, Lord, your direction, so God.
We pray and come against
it. In the name of the Lord Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Holy Spirit, grant us grace.
Your life will be pleasing
that Lord
to God.
Will be blessed to you.
In the mighty name
of Jesus. Yes, Lord, we pray. We call upon your name, O Lord. Under your leadership. We pray that, Lord, you will come to us. We pray that, Lord, you will lead in the name of the Lord Jesus. We seek your wisdom, O God. We seek your leadership, O God. We ask that, God, you will guide us, Lord. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Holy Spirit of the living God, we are before your throne. We know that you are a God of promise. Your promises are yea and amen. We quote unto your promise. We believe that your promise never fails. And so, Lord, we thank you. We thank you, Lord. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you honor, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. Our God and our Master. Lift up your name, O Lord. Be thou exalted. Be thou lifted, O God. For you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We bow our knees, O God, to worship. You care, you care, you care about us.
God says that I have good plans for you. Plans to prosper you. And not to harm you. Plans to give you a good and expected end. This is the promise of God for your life. This is the promise of God for your life. Beloved, lift up your marriage also to God. Lift up your marriage to the Lord. Pray that it shall be well. Pray against any barrenness in your marriage. Come against every barrenness in your marriage. We pray that there shall be a miracle. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus. You will be fruitful. You will be a mother of children. You will be a father of children. Children, there will be laughter in your home. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. What the doctors have said is impossible. We declare that it is possible. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says that God who calls things that are dead, He brings things that are dead to life. And calls things that are not as though they were. He is God. He alone is God. Pray, pray, pray for fruitfulness in your marriage. Let there be joy in your marriage. Let there be peace in your marriage. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. Pray for your business and your profession. Pray that there will be fruitfulness in your business. Pray that when you sow a seed, there shall be fruitfulness. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Jesus
Christ. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ. When we plant, it shall bear fruit. When we plant, we shall bear fruit. Even in barren places, we shall reap a hundredfold. Even if we go in the desert, God will make waters flow in the desert. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we are praying, beloved. Pray, pray, pray. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lift up your business to the Lord. Lift up your profession to the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. For wisdom. Pray for direction. In the name of Jesus. God is able to make a way where there is no way. In the name of Jesus Christ. The business might look like it is going down, but God can lift up the business again. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the 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 name of Jesus. I believe that there is someone whom you are planning to make an investment.
Investment.
But because of this COVID-19, you had to put all your plans on hold. Beloved, we are going to pray again that the enemy cannot destroy your plans.
Jesus.
Your plans will not have a stillbirth.
In Jesus' name.
That you will be able to plant and reap. Whatever the Lord has laid on your heart concerning your investment, we pray that the season will come, that what we are going through shall pass. Shall we lift it up before the Lord?
Hey,
Lord, lift up your plans. Lift up your plans. Lift up your plans to the Lord. Lift up your plans to the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ, Mantara Broderi Babe Candelia, Meshandara Babe Candela, Broderi Babe Candelia, Meshandara Babe Candela, Meshandara Babe Candela, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name,
amen.
Beloved, I believe that there are people who are sick and they are
in their homes.
But I want to tell you that we have a healer
in Jesus.
This healer is not a human being. He is God. He is our creator. And by his stripes, you are healed. We want to pray for those who are sick in the home. Those who are even afraid to go to the hospital. Because they believe that they will get infected. And they are trying to manage it. We believe that the power of God can touch you where you are. And God can bring healing to you. Wherever you are, I want you to stretch forth your hand towards your screen. Stretch forth your hand towards the screen.
Jesus.
And we are going to pray. We are standing with you in prayer. And believing that God will heal you. That by his stripes you were healed.
Jesus.
Shall we begin prayer? Shall we begin prayer? In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray, Father, your healing touch, your healing hand over your people. In the name of Jesus Christ, O God, as they stretch forth their hands, O God, Father, touch them, O God, from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet, O God. In the name of Jesus Christ, let your healing hand touch them. Make Karabonte Montoro Gosta Kataya Mandia, Huya Bashanderi Babe Kataya Mandia. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the mighty name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, the Bible says that God sent his word and he healed their sicknesses. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, there is power in the name of Jesus, there is healing in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Makanderi babe kanderi babaya. Mendoro bos kanderi babe karabos kanderi babaya. In the name of Jesus.
We plead the blood. The blood.
In Jesus' name.
Our Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Beloved, we are going to take up one serious prayer. What is holding people all over the world at this moment? Is this COVID-19 or coronavirus?
COVID-19, coronavirus.
Today we are going to pray and bind the spirit behind this virus. We are going to pray and declare that greater is he who is in us than he that is in the world. Beloved, shall we begin prayer?
And come
against every spirit that is behind this virus. Lift up a standard. The Bible says when the enemy shall come in like a flood, the spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard against
him.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we come against every virus. We come against the spirit behind this virus. In the name of Jesus Christ, make Karabo Sandalabari. Make Kandalabaya Mandia. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus Christ, beloved, all over the world in various homes, this virus has held people captive.
Yes, Lord.
We are going to pray. Look, prayer knows no boundaries. In whatever country they are, we are going to pray that there will be healing for these people. In the name of Jesus Christ. Not only in Ghana, but all over the world. Let's lift up our prayer. Lift up our prayer one more time. Lift up your prayer one more time. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lift up your prayer, brother. Lift up your prayer, sister. Lift up your prayer. Lift up your prayer. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus, 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 in Jesus' name, amen,
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 in Jesus' name,
beloved. Over this period of time, we have people who are grieving. They are grieving because they've lost loved ones. And somehow, maybe they could not give them a fitting burial as they had wanted. We are going to pray that the God of all comfort, wherever you are, if you've lost a loved one, we are praying that the God of all comfort will comfort you. God will bring peace into your life. God will bring joy one more time into your life. Beloved, shall we lift up these people in prayer? Lift them up in prayer. Lift them up in prayer. Lift them up in prayer. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lord, you are God. You are God. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. Lift them up in for the Lord. He is the God of all comfort. He is the God of compassion and mercy. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. May God hold them. May God hold them up. May God lift them up. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. May God comfort their hearts. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. May Kanderi Babaya. Manderi Babosarabokara Bostanarabaya. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Beloved, we hear also that because of the lockdown, there are people in their homes who are having tension and pressure, husbands against wives, children against their parents. We want to pray that whatever the enemy has brought, division that the enemy has brought into homes, shall be driven away in the name of Jesus Christ.
Yesu Kristo dimi ya bom pa yesa. San se ya ma ye share dem kakra no. Ntawantawa epiepie wawarefo na ene ma agya ene mantem. Ya bom pa yesa asumdwe yin no. Ebe bom na asumdwe aye mfie mfie abusu nyina ma.
Oh beloved, let us lift up prayer. Let us pray. Let us lift up prayer. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray for peace in the name of Jesus. Wherever the enemy has placed division, we pray that there will be unity, there will be love, there will be oneness in the name of Jesus Christ. Let husbands love their wives. Let wives love their husbands. Let children obey their parents in the name of Jesus. Christ, make Kanderi Babaya Mandea, Rabastenderi Babe Kandea, Mendoro Gondori Babe Kandea, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus,
we pray, O God.
We pray with thanksgiving.
Beloved, want to pray for the church. That even in a time like this, the word of God will be preached powerfully. That we will see even this social media as another window of opportunity. That the church will be revived. Will be revived to prayer. And to obedience to God. Shall we lift up prayer? Lift up prayer for the church. Let's pray in the name of Jesus Christ, O God. We pray, Heavenly Father, that you bless your church, O God. The gates of hell shall not prevail against the church. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray that souls shall be born into the kingdom of God. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ. Randala be kanderi babe kanderi babe kataya mandia. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray that the church will be stronger, will come out stronger and better. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Beloved, we want to lift up our last prayer. We want to lift up prayer for the country. We want to pray that the blood of Jesus Christ shall cover the whole country. The Bible says that when I see the blood, I will pass over you.
Bible says,
beloved, let's lift up our country to the Lord. Pray for your country. Pray for Ghana. Pray for our nation. Cover our nation with the blood of Jesus Christ. Pray against any principality and power that's been assigned against our nation. Pray for the leaders of the nation. That God will grant them wisdom. God will grant them wisdom. Even as they go through this period, that God will show them what to do. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. We cover the nation with the blood of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Pray for the businesses in the country. Pray that they will come out stronger and better. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
God, hallelujah.
Beloved, I want you to make this declaration with me. Say, this too shall pass.
This too shall pass.
I want you to say it again, that this too shall pass.
This too shall pass.
Everything that is afflicting you shall pass. Coronavirus shall pass.
Coronavirus shall pass.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Let us round up with this scripture, Psalm 91, verse 15 to 16. The Bible says that he will call on me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. In Jesus' name. Now make this declaration again. That God said it. I believe it. That settles it. Oh, let's say it one more time. God said it. I believe it. That settles it. For the last time. God said it. I believe it. That settles it. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord.
Praise
the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Come on, celebrate the Lord. Hallelujah. Put your hands together and Hallelujah. Bless his name.
Hallelujah.
Oh, what a wonderful time in the presence of our God. God said it, I believe it, and it's settled. God said it, I believe it, I receive it, and it is settled. In Jesus' name, amen. That was the voice of Reverend Dan Annan of Calvary Baptist Church. And Mrs. Selina Dega just woke up with interpretation. We thank God for the time in his presence. Oh, there's no place like the presence of God. And tonight we have received that unction to pray. And we believe that God will answer every prayer. Now you are listening to Calvary Baptist Church. We are at Shashi. We are at Abraka, Botiano, Oyibi, and Amasaman. Now, we want to reach out to the pastors for counseling. We have our numbers that are scrolled. And you can pick any of the numbers and call. You'll be helped. Maybe you're going through a difficult time and you need somebody to stand with you. We are always available. Our doors are open. We want you also to know that our church office is open from Monday to Friday, from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. For church members who want to come in and pay their tithes and bring their offerings, you are welcome, because the work of God must still go on. We are reaching out and touching many people. So God bless you as you come into his presence. It's been a wonderful time coming all the way from Calvary Baptist Church under the leadership of our senior pastor, Reverend Dr. Fred Digby. We love you so much and we thank God for your life. We want to close by singing this song, Never Failed Me Yet. You know, Reverend Anna said that the people, Abraham and Sarah, at the point gave up on the promise of God. But I want you to know that whatever you are going through, God will never fail you. So we want to sing this song together. Believe it. God said it. Believe it. Receive it. And it will happen. Let's go.
Never failed me yet. Never failed me yet. Jesus Christ has never failed me yet.
Oh, come on, it's your song. It's your song.
That's one thing.
Oh, la la, nie.
Sign
to me. Are you good, yeah? Are you good, yeah?
Everywhere.
Oh, la la, nie. Oh, Achichea. It's your song. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Has never failed me.
Let's take it again. Lift up your hand and sing it to the Lord. Believe that God has not failed.
You
die. Jesus Christ,
our
But let's take the English version. The English version.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, every promise of God, every promise of God will be fulfilled. It does not matter how long it takes. It does not matter how long it takes. The promises of God are yea and amen. And God will surely do it.
Has never failed me.
That's one thing
I do know.
Everywhere
I go,
Jesus Christ
has never failed
me.
Yeah.
We are on Facebook, Calvary Baptist Church GH, and on YouTube, Calvary Baptist Church TV. And on Sunny FM 88.7 on Sunday. And of course, Power FM 97.9 on Sundays. God bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you. In Jesus' name. We love you, but God loves you best.